A cyclist starts pedaling and accelerates for 12 seconds. The velocity, v of t, of the cyclist at 2 second intervals in feet per second is given by the table. So they tell us at different times. So after 4 seconds, velocity is 7.5 feet per second. After 8 seconds, velocity is 9 feet per second. Consider the graph of velocity versus time. Velocity versus time. Let capital R of 6 be the sum of the areas of 6 right-hand rectangles with equal subdivisions. It follows that capital R of 6 is an approximation for the total distance traveled in feet during the 12 seconds. What is the value of capital R of 6? So I encourage you to pause this video and try to think about it on your own, and then I'll work through it. And any time while I'm working through it, if you get inspired, feel free to pause again and try to take it all the way. So let's think about what they're saying. They say, consider the graph of velocity versus time. So we might as well try to plot that. And so got some graph paper here. And we can focus on the first quadrant because all of our time values and all of our velocity values are positive. So let's see, this is time. This is velocity as a function of time axis. Time goes between 0 and 12, and they're giving it to us in every 2 seconds. So this is 0, 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, and 12 seconds. And then our velocity goes between 0 and 10 feet per second. So this is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. I'll just mark off some of them. 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. And this is in feet per second. And this over here is in seconds. So let's plot these points. At time 0, velocity is 0. Time 2, velocity is 6 feet per second. Time 4, it's 7.5, gets us right there. Time 6, it's 8.5. That's 8.5. Time 8, it 8 seconds, it's 9 feet per second. At 10 seconds, it's 9.5 feet per second. And at 12 seconds, it's 10 feet. It's 10 feet per second. And so what I've done here is I've just plotted the data that they've given us. I'm considering the graph of velocity versus time, at least the data they've given us. And so we can imagine fitting a curve that looks something like this. If we were to, that you know, these points are just sampled from a curve that might look something like this over there. So we are now considering the graph of velocity versus time. Now let's think about the sum of the areas of 6 right-handed rectangles with equal subdivisions. So when they're talking about equal subdivisions, they're talking about equal subdivisions along the independent axis, or the time axis in this case. And we're talking about the first 12 seconds. And so if we were to divide the first 12 seconds into 6 equal sections, they would each be 2 seconds wide. So this would be one of them. Let me do this in a new color. So they would each be 2 seconds. That's not a new color. Oh, it is blue. So they're each going to be 2 seconds. Let me do one that contrasts with green better. So they're each going to be, each of our rectangles are going to be 2 seconds wide. And I'm just kind of starting them off at the bottom because we have to think about how tall to make them. And then they say to do right-handed rectangles. So what's a right-handed rectangle? So that means we define the height of the rectangle by the value of the function on the right-hand side. So for example, this first rectangle, to make it a right-handed rectangle, we look at, okay, the right side, we're at 2 seconds. Velocity at 2 seconds is 6 feet per second. And so that's going to be the height, that's going to be the height of our rectangle. And so this next one is going to look like this. Now you might say, well, what's a left-handed rectangle then? Well, a left-handed rectangle would be doing something like, okay, for this first rectangle on the left-hand side of it, my function is 0. So it's just 0. Then the next rectangle, the left-hand side, my function at 2 seconds, the function is 6 seconds. So the left-hand rectangles would look like this, would look something like that. But anyway, they're telling us to do right-handed rectangles, so let's do right-handed rectangles. So let me clear this a little bit. All right, so this is that's our first right-handed rectangle. This is our second one. Let me just draw the tops. Third, fourth, fifth, and sixth. That was the tops of them. And it's just going to look something like this. It's going to look like this. So that's my third one. That's my fourth one. That's my fifth one. And then this is my, that's my sixth one. And they're telling us that let capital R of 6 be the sum of the areas of these things. And they tell us that it follows that capital R of 6 is an approximation for the total distance traveled in feet during the 12 seconds. Now, why is that? Why is the sum of these areas an approximation for the total distance traveled? Well before calculus, you learned that if you have a constant rate, that distance is equal to rate times time. Now, once again, this is assuming that assumes a constant rate. Now, our rate in this example is clearly changing. We are clearly accelerating right over here. But maybe we can approximate the distance traveled if we assume a constant rate over an interval, say over 2 second intervals, and then we try to roughly, when we assume some velocity over that interval. Now, when we take these right-handed rectangles, let's just focus on this first rectangle. If I'm taking the area of this first rectangle, what am I doing? I'm multiplying its height times its width. Its height is going to be the velocity at the end of the 2 seconds, and its width is the 2 seconds. So if I were to multiply 6 feet per second times 2 seconds, that'll get me 12 feet. Let me make that very clear. So the area for that one, area is equal to 6 feet per second, my velocity. It's actually the speed, but we'll just assume we're not going to get particular about whether we're getting the direction as well. 6 feet per second times 2 seconds. Well, that's going to get me 12 feet. Now, that we can say is an approximation because we're saying, okay, you traveled for 2 seconds at some speed, at some velocity, but is that going to be an overestimate or an underestimate? Well, it's going to be an overestimate because you're taking the fastest velocity of the interval. The interval started with the cyclist going 0 feet per second. So it's clearly overestimating it. And if you think about it, and I encourage you to pause the video and think about it on your own, if we did a left-handed rectangle, it would be underestimating it because we'd be taking the slowest velocity over the interval and multiplying it by the interval. But this is an approximation. But let's just calculate what R of 6 is. So R of 6 is going to be the area of this rectangle, which is, as we just said, it's 6 feet per second times 2 seconds. So it's going to be 12 feet. And then we have this rectangle, which is going to be, let's see, this is 7.5 feet per second times 2 seconds, which is going to be 15 feet. And you can even see it in the area right over here. It's going to be 3 feet more, 1, 2, and then half of 2 of these, so it's going to be 3 feet more. And then the area of this one, which is going to be 8.5, so our velocity at the end of the interval is 8.5 feet per second times 2 seconds, which is 17 feet. And then plus this area, which is our velocity at the end of the interval, which is, what is that? That's 9 feet per second times 2 seconds, so plus 18. And then we get the velocity of this area, which is going to be this height, the velocity at the end of the interval, which is 9.5 feet per second times 2 seconds, so plus 19. And then finally this area, which is the velocity at the end of the interval, which is 10 feet per second times 2 seconds, so plus 20. And so what does this give us? And this is the point at which I'm most likely to make an error. So 12 plus 15 is 27. And then 27 plus 10 is 37, plus another 7 is 44. So that gives us 44. 44 plus 18 is going to give me, let's see, I can get to 52 and then 62. So this is going to be 62 plus 19 is, let's see, that's 81, plus 20 is 101. That's going to be in feet. So capital R of 6, 101 feet, which is going to, it is an approximation for the total distance traveled during the 12 seconds, but it's really an over approximation because we, for every interval, we're taking the fastest velocity in the interval. If we took the slowest velocity interval, it would be an underestimate if we did left-handed rectangles. And we might have gotten something in between if we maybe took the average of these two. So if we made the height of the rectangle, 3 for this first one or something like that. But we'll do that in future videos.